Hey there everybody, this is Spiraling Helix. Welcome back to Super Mario Galaxy. In the last episode, we completed the Trial Galaxies, bet our speed rate. We put another record on one of the stars, but we finished off every star that is in this game. And now we have the power to travel to another world. And first, before we do that, we must defeat Bowser and save our special one. So, now that we aren't ready, in my opinion, yet, we have to do a few things first. Now, it may look like I have 26 lives, but you're imagining things. The first thing I must do is collect every life that is around the observatory. And we've seen quite a few of these around before, so that's the first one. Sorry there, Luma. That's the first one available. Along with this one here. Although I can't remember if you need the kitchen active to get this one. Then all the way up here, we have one hiding around here. Oh, come on. There we go. Then we have one up underneath the gate. And then, of course, right on top of the observatory. Just a little preparation work I've put in. But with this, I think we are now ready to go fight Bowser. And I do want to show something off first. If I fly all the way over here. Come on. Come on. There we go. Let's just ground pound speed it up. You get launched all the way through the observatory back to where you were. That's what I love doing with the flying. Oh. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't have done that. But, I think we're ready, guys. Let's take on Bowser. And before anything happens, I haven't forgotten about the library. I'll cover that in a bonus episode because it is so slow. But, let's talk to Rosalina and be on our way. Are you prepared to travel to the center of the universe? Yes. Alright then, off we go. Here we are. Pre-rendered cutscene by the looks of it. And the observatory is moving around quite a bit. It's cool how you can see the different parts of the observatory working together. Like those platforms that turn slowly. But with that, the observatory has the full power of its comet form yet again. So we make our way to the center of the universe. Clearly labeled out in this weird void. And just going straight through those ships. UFO's off in the top left corner. Although we don't really care about any of those. There is a warp field inside the castle.
Go, Mario.
Go, they are inside, hurry. English! There is actually English in this that isn't what's Mario's name. Or screaming. I guess that is an English song. But with that, we have weird platforms forming around in front of us. Thankfully, due to Rosalina. And we are heading into Mario 64. And now we have to jump into all the paintings inside. I've already got this far. But the fate of the universe is in our hands in Bowser's Galaxy Reactor. Don't skip the cutscenes. Don't skip the cutscenes. That is one big planet. But here we go. What do you have to say? Mama says this fight isn't just for us. It's about saving your special one. Please be careful. Whatever you do, don't fail! I'll try. Those spotlights have their own gravity. Try sticking to them. What, like this? Wahoo! Oh, I guess just jump over the... What? So much for their own gravity. So that's the first death of this place. Can I get in? Thank goodness. So yeah, they do have their own gravity. It's, I'm going to say, weaker than other forms of gravity that Bowser has used. And I only say that with how quickly Mario actually goes to the spotlights. And by the way, speaking of like already dying on the first planet, I did record my previous attempt, like my previous way through this star to unlock all the purple comets. And I'll probably put together some highlights, because I died a lot of times trying to do this. But, got quite a few planets. They're all very bright, so it looks like we got a star there, a fiery star here, an icy one there, some desert, and a tower. Then Bowser must be over there somewhere. An amount of water. Blah. Anyway, let's move on. And let's just long jump over here. Long jump and fireballs. Whoop. Get this. I did not see that coming. Oh no. Come on, come on. No, no, no. Oh wow. How am I alive? How am I alive? No, 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 no. Oh no, no, no. That was going so well. And by so well, I mean so badly, but I was staying alive for so long there. But, another thing speaking about dying, I have been unable to show off a game over screen in this. And it's really not much, it's just after you lose your last life. Like, Bowser's face will close down on the screen like normal, that's the blackout thing. And then it'll just say, game over. And I think you just, like, you can choose to continue or not. And I think you just spawn at the beginning of the star. I'm right. Oh no. Okay. Let's get all these one. No! Oh, come on. No, no, I'm stuck beneath the blocks. This is actually looking a lot like the death cycle last one, although I don't think I died on the spotlights in the first planet. But yeah, I failed to show off a game over screen. When it does happen, I think you get the choice to continue, and it'll just... That got me from a lot higher up than I thought. I will get through this! But yeah, I think you just start at the beginning of the star, so like, if I got a game over here. Oh, in case you guys are wondering, there's an invisible wall, so I can't just do a long jump backwards. But this coin will thankfully give my health back. Thank you. And let's just go this way. Avoid that one up from now on, it's causing more deaths than it is causing life. But, moving on, or already got the star, that's all this. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Mario, please face forward next time I start that. Okay, one up here, one up up here. I'm saying, no, 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 no. Oh well, I think I'm good. And they do disappear and they don't reappear if we wait too long. Moving on, and I think this is a checkpoint. Please be a checkpoint, because chances are I'm gonna die here as well. Oh no, oh no. Okay, going good, going good. I'm fine. I'm gonna make it. I'm gonna make it. No, no, no! No, 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 don't, don't. Well, I guess I'll find out if there's a checkpoint there. I don't think I've ever died there. No, there wasn't a checkpoint. Oh, of course there wasn't a checkpoint. Why would there ever be a checkpoint in a game on the final level? I mean, this game puts checkpoints everywhere, but now suddenly final level? No. Judging by how many times I've died, I'm gonna say the difficulty's gone up quite a bit. And I think the textures on this planet freaked out a bit. And let's just skip all of this. We've seen this so many times. Go on, get in the spotlight. Onwards! This... I don't even want to try long jumping to... No, no, no. Oh, come on! Well, thankfully there are so many lives here, I'm not gonna game over. I can be happy with that. Well, this is certainly proving to be a decent final level. Seeing as I keep dying, I'm pretty sure this is already the most amount of times I've died on any stage. So, yay for Bowser, you did a decent job this time. Wahoo! That did not take me as far as I hoped. And over here. Here we go! Onwards! Okay. Wait, is there a tornado? Wait a minute, there's a... There's something on this planet I've never seen before. Why would there be a tornado there? I have to find out, guys. There's a secret on this planet. It's the only one I've seen that doesn't have a one-up, to be honest. I mean, there's got to be a reason for tornadoes being on it. There has to be. How do I get... You know, that's going to kill me if I don't kill it. It's that. Like, maybe the one over here? Whereabouts was it? Where was it? Over there. Maybe I can make that. Please. Nope. Okay, maybe there isn't a secret and it's just a tornado for the sake of being a tornado. It's like that Sling Star. It's exactly like that Sling Star in Dreadnought Purple Coins. That was really annoying. But I haven't made a point of this yet. The music is actually really good. It's not as good as some of the other places. It's the way I describe the final level music here. It's less like final level and it's more so just like it's it sounds sort of final level because you don't really hear anything sort of like this, but it's sort of like this is it, something's gonna happen, but it doesn't quite feel like it sums up the game too well. And I guess I'm not getting that, because if I get that, platforms here will disappear, and I need those. No! See? I needed those platforms, and they just disappeared from right under me. The intro certainly gives the fear, the vibe. This is it, final level, we've come this far. But, let's do this properly this time. The fire bars are on a different cycle. Wait for you, then wait for you, and then long jump! Okay. By the way, in case you're wondering, there was a checkpoint on that last one, so I can just go and die 20 times yet again. But, got some bullet bills, thwumps, and a whole lot of gravity weirdness with some other... No, I'm getting that one. Oh, no. That was so close. I bonked my head. No, don't kill me. Don't kill me. Okay, get on this. Yeah, let's just take this all the way around. La-dee-da-dee-da. And it's a bonsai. I can make that. Cool, I made it. Have we seen bonsai bills before? I'm saying bonsai, but it's banzai or something, aren't they? It's an A, not an O. It's a Z. Oh no. Make it, please! Oh, that was so close. Come on. Okay, this one. Coins! Give me those coins! Please! Give me those coins! No! Give me that coin! Okay, I think I made it. Banzai Builder, I think that's what they're called. I don't remember seeing them anyways. There he is! It's Bowser. But first, it's Bowser Jr. Looking for Princess Peach? Too bad, because she's with me. Oh, he's angry. Look at Bowser just staring at us. Bowser Jr. dancing up there. That's what's about the rest of the level unloaded, like always. And no, it's actually all still there. That's a first, but moving onwards. Something's not right. Ha! I knew he didn't finish his laugh, I knew it. But with that, Bowser Jr.'s cool. They're coming way quicker than I thought. We have our health back though. Oh no. Come on. Get this. Keep moving. Here we go. We have made it to the big guy himself, Bowser. Bowser Jr., he's just gonna sit there with his mask on. You got here just in time to see the creation of my galaxy in the center of the universe. Watch and weep. It's a big planet of lava. From this galaxy, I rule a great galactic empire with Peach by my side. It will last forever. I will rule every pitiful corner of the universe. So, Mario, as you can see, I got big plans, and stopping you is at the top of my list. Rawr! Here we go, this is it. Our final fight with Bowser. Here we go, just gotta jump over some lasers, and already he's showing off some new things, and all you have to do is spin him on the head, just like any of those boulders that he looks like. And he can roll into the spiny things to give you star bits or coins if you need it. Here we go, do it one more time. There we go. I feel like the hitbox on Bowser is a lot bigger than on those boulders though. There we go, one more hit. And we are off to another planet. And now he breathes fire, but you can just take cover behind a tree. Then he turns into this giant spike shell. Don't see how he grows another shell, but oh well. Come on. Bowser, come out here, please. Please, Bowser. There we go. One more hit. We'll do it. And seriously, if he just used that spiny shell on the last planet, then we wouldn't have been able to hurt him, but the tactic I usually do is hide behind a tree from the fire and then just spin when he's coming straight at you. Come on, hit him. Here we go. And another weird orb. You only saw this orb in the observatory, but you see it here, which is interesting. Here we go. And before I talk about this, it's the same thing we've always seen, but I'm just gonna be quiet here, because the music here is epic! I mean, it gets not quiet, it's sort of building up to a bit. But, here we go, now he's angry, one more time, should do it. Fireballs everywhere. Five lasers, jump them all, dodge his shell, and he moves quickly, that was close. There we go. One more hit, come on, come on, this is it, this is it, coming up to the best part of the music as well. Come on, hit him, and I don't want to hit him yet because of the music. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Okay, with that is it, guys. We have defeated Bowser as he falls into his creation. And there is one. I'm gonna start questioning a few things very soon, but we'll wait for that. And with that, of course, spawning from the planet that we're actually standing on this time, it's the final grand star. This last one that is clear, because I've already done this, but just pretend it's all filled in and lovely and golden. Actually, I have an even better idea. It is lovely and golden. You're just imagining things. Actually, I wonder, does it go gold in the cutscene? If it doesn't, I'll just put in the other footage I have, but I think it goes gold here. Yeah, it does. Okay, cool. Here's our cutscene, and how on... Okay, number one. How does Bowser Jr. lose control of Peach, and how does he end up off his airship and spinning in, out of control? Okay, that's number one. And we return back to the start of this galaxy so we can exit through the castle. And we've got this big star I pointed out earlier, but we never went to it. Number two, this planet or star or whatever, I'm calling it a star. If you look at the background, it's moving. It's just teleporting to like eight different places. It's ridiculous. So it's never in the same place it was at during the level. And then it changes in every part of the cutscene. But Bowser, number three, Bowser somehow ends up on this thing after the big I'm ruining this! Why am I doing this? It's like everything was going so well with the entire game until these cutscenes. Oh well. No! My galaxy! My empire! This can't be happening! And with that, we have actually defeated Bowser, once and for all. He shall never be returning as a black hole forms, and the Grand Star just ditches us. And the Cognit Observatory has lost all its power again. Although the bedroom's lit up, that's weird. Everything's breaking apart. And I don't think I see the UFO in any of that. Oh well, and it's our baby Luma, huh. Number 4, what on earth is going on here? But, just saying, that bit with the Lumas all sacrificing themselves, that bit is so touching. But with that, Rosalina has grown into a giant, or just appearing in a vision, I guess, as we are falling into the afterlife? I don't know. Do you hear the baby stars? These newborns will grow up to become galaxies someday. When stars die, they turn to stardust and scatter across the cosmos. Eventually, that stardust reforms to create a new star, and so the cycle of life continues. But the cycle never repeats itself in quite the same way. So, you'll see. So I guess all those Lumas sacrificing themselves for us didn't actually all just die as they get reborn? Huh. Oh well. And we are back in the Mushroom Kingdom on the day after, I'm gonna guess it's the day after the Star Bit Festival, Comet Festival, I completely forgot the name of it. And got Guppy and a little robot and some beads. Here we go. Got everyone from our adventure, even bad guys like Bowser Jr. there. Everyone's here celebrating, Toads and Goombas alike. Got a cheat sheet, happily. Got Peach. All safe and sound. And there's Bowser. Everyone's celebrating the new world. As Peach longingly looks into Bowser's eyes. Yes, all new life carries the essence of stars, even all of you.
Ah. Welcome! Welcome, new galaxy!
What, the Good Egg Galaxy and Gusty Garden? Very close by for some reason, but with that, that is Super Mario Galaxy! And what an ending! Seriously, that boss fight is amazing. That galaxy is actually a lot tougher than I thought. Main game made by Shigeru Miyamoto. amongst others, as we now see in these credits. And that planet in Deep Dark Galaxy. We're playing a game now. Guess the Galaxy. But, had a lot of fun with this game, actually. There's still quite a few things I do have to show off. And I'll throw them all into a bonus episode with the thing. And I feel like I don't even need to show off highlights from the last time I did that Galaxy, because I died just as many times, if not even more. But, got a lot of dry bones after Mario there. Boss character programming, I didn't think that was actually a thing, just for bosses, huh. Although he probably did other things too. And Bone Finn there, he actually proved tougher than I thought as well. But with this game in total and this project, actually had a lot of fun. Struggled quite a bit to manage the comments later on, but had a lot of interesting moments, especially with, like, had a few brief little glitches with Mario landing on something, but struggled on a few stars. Purple comments went way easier than I thought they would, probably for the better. Sea Slide was a little bit boring. I was feeling a bit blur on that day as well, but got a miniature Gateway Galaxy. It's in the Deep Dark, actually. Fiery Piranha. Oh, no. I don't think I can actually say what that is the Hariskari Galaxy in the bottom left, because Sea Slide had the beach background. And I don't remember there being watermelons. That is actually a bonus that I will not be able to show off as easily. Charles Martinet, thank you very much for voicing Mario. And the Mario Galaxy Orchestra, they performed, I don't think it was the complete soundtrack in this game, probably majority of it. Everything you've heard in majority of the soundtracks are live orchestrated. Some bits here and there aren't. I think about half the game in terms of main galaxies is, but there's our good old pal Luigi. A lot of debugging there. European localization did a fairly good job there. There's Rosalina, the only English speaking character apart from names. I was gonna say something else, but like this soundtrack here is even, it's amazing what these guys have done. I'm really into soundtracks, if you couldn't guess. Alright, that's what I was throwing off. Watermelons. So, if you somehow manage to collect, I believe it's 9,999 star bits, I think, then all coconuts will turn into watermelons, says the producers, and Satoru Iwata, of course. And with that, the end. Although there is one thing I should mention.
Thank you so much for playing my game.
Thank you. But with that, first things first, this doesn't appear once you beat the game for the first time. This only appears once you've got all 120 stars and then you complete the game. I forgot this bonus cutscene actually existed and something else would happen. There's Rosalina at the Gateway Galaxy, overlooking another world, perhaps?
Thank you.
I will watch over you from beyond the stars. And as the Comet Festival comes to an end, the tradition with the Comet Observatory approaching the Mushroom Kingdom once every 100 or 1,000 years, I can't remember which one, comes to pass. And Rosalina must move on. With that, the Comet Observatory seeks out more stars. Or, I mean, it searches amongst the stars for more. Got a starship here, a bit grown over. And baby Loma got left behind, huh?
Super Luigi Galaxy!
You can now play as Luigi! So, that is the Another World Saver game. I have to this time, because then that wouldn't happen. So, with that, we are back at the main menu. The episode's gone on long enough already. But next time in our bonus video, first off, if I select ours, you can see two crowns now in Mario's face as well. And I don't see a death count, but if you just hit this icon here, you can now play as Luigi. So in the next episode, our bonus episode, also you can see I've been working on one here, we will show off the main differences between Mario and Luigi that isn't just like text and dialogue going, oh, it's Luigi instead of, oh, it's Mario. Or other way around. No? Right, that was wrong. So we'll show off everything to do with Luigi that is different. And we will also show off the library for once and read that whole story. And last of all, there is one other thing I will show off. And hopefully I don't take forever to actually do that, because it needs a little bit more work done off camera. But with that, guys, this has been Super Mario Galaxy. I will see you guys either in the next bonus episode, as I keep saying, or in my next playthrough. Whatever that shall be. See you guys next time. This is Spiraling Helix signing out for the last time. No, it isn't. Oh well. Bye-bye, everybody.